شغالة معي
شغالة
السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. اللهم لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم. اللهم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم. أسأل الله سبحانه وتعالى يتقبل منا يا الله سبحانه وتعالى. Accept more fast and peace inshallah. And this Qiyam and tomorrow's fasting inshallah with the Mawla Azza wa Jalla. What I will be doing now, it will be inshallah. Wait. It will be under the main umbrella of the meaning of the very beautiful verse, وَذَكَّرْ فَإِنَّ الذِّكْرَ تَنْفَعُ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. I will not be bringing something new. وَذَكِّرْ, remind. Because verily, indeed, a reminder does benefit the believers. So I will be quoting a very famous hadith. The only new thing in this hadith is just a reminder. Because sometimes we might not be aware that we have forgotten. Now the hadith is, either, what do you expect? Either what? How many hadiths start with either? Who can guess what I'm planning to say? إذا قامت الساعة في الدهاك مسيرة. What else?
إذا سافر العبد أمور.
إذا إيش؟
سافر العبد أمور كتب
له. إذا سافر العبد أمور كتب له. ما شاء الله يبلغ حديث مئته. What else? من سعد مات عمره. جزاك الله خير. نعم. إذا مات ابن آدم انقطع عمله إلا من ثلاث. ما هؤلاء الثلاث؟ صدقة جارية. علم ينتفع به أو ولد أو ولد صالح حسب يدعو له. Now basically this is a very famous hadith. Thank you, جزاكم الله خير for يعني this kind of support and this kind of sharing. Now if Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, the hadith says, if the son of Adam passed away, nothing will stay as a feeding channel, as a supporting way of ajr, of reward, of thawab, that he will be continuously receiving after passing away from the dunya, except through three main channels. Everything will stop, khalas, except three main channels. Channel number one, sadaqa jariya. This kind, a sadaqa that has the status of jariya, which means still continuously operating and sending the ajr for him. The second one is عِلْمٌ يَنْتَفَعُ بِهِ, a beneficial knowledge. A ilm that does keep benefiting the people, and it has happened because of him. He spread this knowledge, okay? He gave this knowledge. He supported this knowledge. And the third one, وَوَلَدٌ صَالِحٌ أَوْ وَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُ لَهُ. Righteous, pious, you know, offspring. The word walad in Arabic language is applicable on males and females. Walad does not mean boy, be careful. But we use it traditionally as a boy. In Arabic, classical Arabic, walad is applicable on dhakar and untha, on both males and females. Walad also, which means a son or daughter that keeps making dua for him and his good deeds. I think everyone knows this hadith. Now the reminder is, have we done our best to make sure not to leave this dunya before having a guarantee, at least one of these channels is a guarantee in our pockets before leaving this dunya? This is the question. Am I planning to make sure to have just one of those? And the best thing is to have the three. So my reminder is, if you are married, the question is, are you doing your best to plant the seeds of some certain things in your son or daughter to make sure when you pass away that this is a walad salih yad'u lak? Such as, if we made like a quick survey and asked Mr. Father and Mrs. Mother, hello Mr. Father, hello Mr. Mother, are you doing your best to take care of your son? Yes, tell me what are you doing with him. Well, I'm doing my best. I sent him to the best schools. Good. What else? I'm giving him the best food. Good. What else? I'm giving him or I'm sending him to the best sport places. Okay, what else? I'm, excuse me. I'm sorry for embarrassing you. Do you bring him to the masjid? Excuse me? I'm asking, do you bring him to the masjid? No, I don't. Are you doing your best? I'm making an interview now. This is what I mean. This is a mic, okay? I'm interviewing the people. Okay? So, Mrs. Mother, are you doing your best to... Or what do you do your best to teach your daughter? The latest makeup arts or how to wear the hijab when she's out? Are you planning to make her a righteous wife or a professional fighter? Am I exaggerating if I said some mothers, they prepare their daughters to be fighters at home? Yes, من الليل الأولى بدك تعلميه إنك أنت صاحبة الكلمة بده يفهم اسمك أمه العقربة Untranslatable طبعا if some people really I can't translate والله this has to do with the Arabic context I mean, some mother might be feeding their daughters and sons how not to be righteous good sometimes. So what is the priority? So, okay, we know that in theory, most of us, we might cry even when we think about this, alhamdulillah, but am I preparing myself? Is this my priority? So this is the question. This is related to the same category still. If I'm not married yet, talking with singles now, males and females, have you decided to put as a priority in your criteria while searching for a wife or accepting a husband who's coming to ask for my hand if I'm a female, that my criteria of accepting or looking for or choosing is based on a criteria that will lead me and him to have ولد صالح العلماء. What is criteria of looking for my spouse? What is it? Money? And you know the hadith, for example. إذا أتاكم أن ترضونا his bank account, صح شيخ حديث حكى؟ إذا أتاكم أن ترضونا عن رقم حسابه في البنك، شو الحديث؟ وإذا أتاكم أن ترضونا عن موديل سيارته، إذا أتاكم أن ترضونا عن وسامته وسمسمة شعراته، is this حديث؟ Is this the hadith?
No.
إذا أتاكم أن ترضونا عن ترضونا دينه وخلقه فزوجوه إلا تفعلوا تكن في الأرض فتنة وفساد كبير وفساد عريض. If you've been approached by someone who's categorized as righteous, pious with خلق and deen, do your best to accept him and husband. Otherwise, you are delving into the area of fasad, corruption, arid, big as a society, not as a family. Everyone will be suffering from great, huge corruption, subhanAllah. So this is the category. The first one and second one, it was عمل صالح وصدقة جارية. So صدقة جارية و عفوا علم ينتفع به. Now, let me give you the glad tidings. SubhanAllah, even though when I decided to talk about Hadith al-Hadith, the idea that I will be telling you now was not in my mind. But SubhanAllah, it's by the will of Allah. InshaAllah, with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as some of you might have already heard since many weeks, in 3 weeks' time, you will be announcing officially, inshaAllah, that we will be starting under the title of Darul Hikmah. Under the big umbrella of Dar Foundation that you know, inshallah, we'll be starting giving intensive Sharia courses, inshallah, in this place, with the Lord Azza wa Jal. We will be starting, inshallah, intensive course. Each course will be about 20 hours. We're talking about atheism, about fiqh al-usra, how to establish a family, how to choose your spouse, how to deal with your spouse, how to take care of your children, some other courses about introduction to the science of faith, علم العقيدة. Another one will be about comparative religions, how to understand other religions, how to deal with others, how to judge others, how to accept others, how to discuss, how to argue, how to debate. So we will be announcing, inshallah, intensive courses. which would be basically related to which category? If you are interested for yourself to educate yourself with the basics of علم العقيدة or علم مقارنة الأديان or فقه الأسرة or you know such things, please prepare yourself with me and us inshallah to be enrolled in this. Now let's go to category number one, صدقة جارية. If you are in one of the صدقة جارية, by the way, if you can support those who are seeking the ilm and they can't, they can't take one, because it's a paid courses. It's an official paid courses that you have to attend, and it's at least 20 hours attendance of knowledge, inshallah, bin Allah. It happened by the will of Allah that you are planning so. But my idea was just to pay your attention to the fact that, please, let's come out of this qiyam by paying our attention to the fact that to plan either to support Sadaqa Jariya wherever. Some people might be digging a well somewhere in Africa, in Far East, anyway. Some people might be supporting Talib Ilm, anywhere, anyone from ex country, poor country, who's seeking to memorize the Quran, to have the Quran, to come back to educate his people, how to take care of anything, any khair, supporting like a mobile, for example. Mobile trucks in some people which contain some kind of medical treatment helping the people, sometimes small operations. Wallahi, I heard about some organizations just by sending
eye drops.
Wallahi, I heard about some African countries just by bringing eye drops for them, they saved thousands of them from blindness. Ama. قطرة عين تنقذ من عمى، يعني بعضهم يصاب بالعمى فقط لعدم وجود قطرة عين، تخيل؟ I'm not talking about serious diseases. No, just قطرة عين. Small infection, something very needs some simple antibiotic just for this. Some of them, they lose their sight. So look, for example, you can search. If you are interested, you can search if you find. Let's not leave this before making sure that one of these categories I have prepared myself, and I'm doing my best not to leave this dunya before having. And Al-Mahfouz, the lucky one, is the one who will be having
the three of them.
May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help all of you to be from those. Jazakumullah khair. Taqabbalallah ta'atakum wa siyamakum wa qiyamakum. Allahumma ameen. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.